eyes of the world were focused on this little island in the Caribbean Sea.
Although Fidel Castro is not officially a communist,
Fidel Castro, the bearded opportunist, has betrayed his own country. For America, there is danger on the doorstep.
Y por fin, viva Cuba Libre!
This is a murder story. The victim, Fidel Castro, the president of Cuba. Castro never was assassinated. This time, he just tripped over a step. But more people have tried to murder the world's most famous socialist than any man alive. Governments and gunmen have been trying to get Castro for 50 long years, but time is nearly up. The men who tried to kill Castro have spent decades in the shadows. Now they've come forward to reveal their secrets. Who are these men? Heroes or villains? And what made them hate Castro enough to want him dead? On a trip to New York in 1959, even the cops fell in love with him. And he didn't just hand out Cuban cigars. He promised his own people free health and education and the dream of equality. You'd think people would want to copy him, not kill him.
Hello, everyone. We'd like to share our trips with you. And tonight we'll all be going to Cuba. Cuba lies just off the coast of Florida.
Most, or many, American political leaders still have this idea that Cuba rightfully should almost be a part of our dominion. They should do what we want them to do. And that if it weren't for Castro, they probably would. So Castro has come to be seen as this nettlesome figure that we simply can't deal with, who has defied us and jeered at us for almost 50 years and got away with it. Nothing can drive a superpower up the wall faster than that.
When Fidel Castro seized power in 1959, ordinary Cubans were ecstatic. He'd seen off a corrupt regime which had bled the country dry for the benefit of American business and a rich ruling elite. When a dove landed on his shoulder, it looked like divine approval. But not everyone felt blessed.
Most of my family were elated when Castro took over, as were most of the Cuban people. Now, I remember I was not 10 years old when I saw on television a trial, when the first early trials of the revolution. And as the trial was going on, as they were going to process this man for an execution against a firing squad, which was later televised, there were vendors walking around in the audience selling candy and soft drinks. And I was 9 years old and I said, wow, This is not right.
Like hundreds of thousands of middle-class Cubans, Enrique and Sinosa's family fled Castro's revolution for the safety of Miami.
Still they come. Nearly 200 Cuban refugees a day, 5 days a week. They arrive with little more than the clothes on their back. Their cash, houses, land, furniture have long since been signed over to the Cuban government.
Castro's exiles are now pillars of Miami society. Their bitterness has grown with every year Castro has stayed in power.
The majority of the Cuban exile community supports any kind of strategy that will overthrow Castro. If you're eliminating a head of state, you know, who is a dictator, who has been oppressing his people, I think it's totally justified. I myself support anybody who tries to kill Fidel Castro because I think it would do humanity a favor. If the opportunity comes to harm him through violent means, I will gladly do so. I will consider it my duty.
Castro's would-be assassins are ready to confess. Step forward, suspect one. Name, Enrique Ovarez. Occupation, architect. Motivation, betrayal. Fidel's student friend, and one of the first to try to take his life.
That's me and that's Fidel. Here, that's Fidel and that's me. Fidel and that's me. I realized in the years that we go together, that we stay together, that he is not a good person. He always has in his mind only one point, the total power. He don't have family, he don't have friends, he don't have nothing. I heard that people said, no, Fidel is comunista, Fidel no is nothing, Fidel is fidelista, punto. Before him, and that's it.
Ovarez became so disillusioned with Castro that he felt compelled to act.
Liquidarlo físicamente, no hay otra solución. O si no padecerlo, sentarte ahí y esperar.
Just after the revolution, Castro could still be seen on Havana's streets, unconcerned and unprotected. Ovarez was going to gun him down in broad daylight.
Con personas que fueran en una máquina con ametralladora o con pistola y en un lugar donde estuviera que no hubiera un total riesgo de tratar de matarlo, cosa que se podía hacer al principio. Ya después más adelante ha sido imposible. Tú tienes que haber visto miles de películas cómo hacen eso. El día que yo me lo encontré en ese lugar, que estaba en las afueras de un restaurante que se llama Casalta, conversando allí. Tú vienes en la máquina, para, lo mata y te vas en la máquina, tan sencillo como eso.
It sounded simple, but killing a man for the first time is never simple.
I don't pretend to know what goes through a man's mind in a situation like this, you know, because I think we're all different. And a man might do something today that he might not have the mentality to do 6 months from now, because human beings are psychologically fragile. But I would say that a man who puts himself in a situation where he actually goes out on the field and actually puts himself within grasp, he should be committed to do, you know, what he set out to do. I don't think it's being, from my own perspective, I wouldn't see any excuse for that. You know, you're there, and nobody hired you to do this. This is something that you volunteered to do. This is something that before you went into, you were totally aware of the circumstances. So you should be willing to take it to the last level. And if you don't, then you failed. It'd be very hard for a man to live with himself after that.
Ovaris hesitated, and it cost him his one shot. Castro's agents were onto him, and he was thrown in jail.
De lo único que me arrepiento es no haberlo matado. Aún a costa de mi vida. Le hubiera hecho tanto bien al público y hubiera salvado la vida. De tantos amigos. Forget it. Vamos a hablar de otra cosa.
This was our first suspect's final confession. 2 months later, Enrique Ovarez, who was ill with cancer, did take a life. His own.